Most of us have very fond memories of The Force Unleashed, not great memories of The Force Unleashed 2, which this story actually takes place on. You see, after the events that transpired in The Force Unleashed 1, it is now left to the rogue clone of Starkiller to pick up every single memory that had been left behind by the original host, which was Galen Merrick. Throughout the game, we start to put the pieces together for the rogue clone, for him to understand his past and how this would lead to his future. And with this came his visit to Dagobah. Now, we all know that during the Imperial time, Obi-Wan was hiding out on Tatooine and subsequently protecting young Luke Skywalker. In the meantime, however, Yoda was hiding out on Dagobah. The Clone Wars series show it perfectly well why actually Yoda went on to pick Dagobah for his future exile. In a way, you could say that Yoda anticipated everything, but that's veering off the topic. Let's go back to how Starkiller decided to go to Dagobah. There is a line actually from Rom Koda, which tells the clone of Starkiller to go to the forests of Kashyyyk or the caves of Dagobah or wherever you think you'll find what you need and let the galaxy die. By this time, of course, we see that Rom Koda is a broken man. Galen Merrick goes on to drop off Rom Koda on Malastare, but soon thereafter, Starkiller followed up on both of his force visions and hints that Rom Koda had inadvertently dropped. He first traveled to Dax City on Mon Cala. He found the planet in turmoil from recent resistant activity. This is all Legends material, but in canon, we all know how Mon Cala ended up. In a way, as George Lucas said, it's like poetry, it rhymes. Both of these storylines are very significant for canon because it lended an echoing timeline that perfectly coincides with what Legends tells us. On the other hand, Kashyyyk, he experienced a vision of the original Starkiller's father. The clone now was starting to put the pieces of the puzzle together. This, however, was nowhere near to what he wanted to achieve, and that is find Juno. He went from freeing Rom Koda to visiting several worlds now, but he had found that all of his attempts to find Juno had proven to be counterproductive to this goal. And so, with having exhausted all the other options, Starkiller decided to travel to Dagobah as a last-minute resort. Once he landed on the planet, immediately feelings of fear overcame him. The novelization of The Force Unleashed kinda details this more specifically, giving Starkiller reason to suspect that the planet itself was a living being, and it was engulfed in darkness, and it was trying to free itself from darkness. It was a planet with a diverse history, to say the least, and the epicenter of darkness was, of course, the Darkseid Cave that is located deep within the swamps. You all know where I'm going next. Once Starkiller left his ship and through the Force started charting a path towards the Darkseid Cave, he started probing the swamps through the Force. He started using the Force to amplify his signature. But in fact, he discovered that an odd Force signature was studying him in return. Somebody was here. Picking his way through the swamps towards this Force being who was probing him, Starkiller would eventually arrive not only to the Darkseid Cave, he would arrive at a green little creature who was standing just at the entrance of the cave. This, of course, as we all know, was Jedi Master Yoda, who had exiled himself on Dagobah for years now, and was just standing there in a non-threatening manner. When Starkiller asked if he is protecting the cave, Yoda merely answered with a simple no, that he is just a watcher of events. He had come to guide Starkiller. Unconsciously, Starkiller knew that this creature was here to guide him through this moment, but the feelings of fear could not let go. Starkiller at this moment feared Yoda more than anything else. It's as if all the strange planet and the strange dark cave, with Yoda it now had a face. The novelization goes on to explain that the feelings that Starkiller felt at this moment were overwhelming, but he tried to stay calm and collected and actually achieve his goal of finding Juno, however it may be. And of course, Yoda helped with seeming non-threatening, actually helping Starkiller for a change once the clone entered entered the cave, he experienced a horrible vision. What we actually don't see in-game, the novelization explains that the first vision is Jedi Knights wielding blue lightsabers. He wandered inside the interior of the cave only to be accosted by various clones of himself. He first ignited his lightsabers trying to fend them off, but eventually he lowered them and forced his way through his clones, realizing that they really don't serve a menacing purpose. He finally entered the final chamber that was shrouded in shadows. He experienced additional layers of this vision, seeing Darth Vader hiring Boba Fett to track him down, and eventually Juno Eclipse being attacked and wounded on the bridge of her vessel, the Salvation. He barely made it out in one piece. His mind was still functioning, and this was a miracle after all he went through inside the dark cave. Once he emerged, Starkiller was again counseled by Yoda to follow what he had seen, to find what he was searching for. This was the culmination of his fear. Starkiller, after what he experienced inside the dark side cave, he came out of it with this little being that was booming in force sensitivity. Starkiller could feel that something was odd with this creature. The creature was the beacon of this planet. He was beaming with force ability, and this gave Starkiller the idea that the entire planet is basically manifesting his fear and this creature alike. It is insinuated in the novelization that he didn't even walk slowly, he walked fast and ran towards his ship just in order to escape the madness that was Dagobah. He had never experienced such a thing in his short-lived life, and he wanted to escape as quickly as possible and never look back. Now, the lessons that he had learned from Yoda and the Dark Side Cave on Dagobah were very precious, to say the least. If you've played the game, then you know that this will lead to an enormous climax inside the game, the finale that is The Force Unleashed 2, and unfortunately we never got a Force Unleashed 3, although now with LucasArts rebranding themselves, you never know. The character itself still remains in Legends, but hope still resides within our hearts that Starkiller might one day be back, officially back in the presence of Star Wars canon. Who knows, a boy can dream, but what do you guys think as well? Would you like to see Starkiller back in canon, and how would you think that could be done? Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up down below, subscribe for dailies. Now you can have an awesome day, Star Wars fans. I'll see you in the next video, and may the Force be with you. Until then.